Everyone, welcome to my channel and greetings from Turkey. My name is Meriç and I'm a mechanical engineer. Today we are going to learn how to make buckling analysis of laminated composite plates and how to make analytical calculations for the given plate. And also we are going to learn the basics of the eigenvalue buckling analysis. And after we applied the eigenvalue buckling analysis, we are going to compare our results to the analytical results. So let's start with eigenvalue buckling analysis. This analysis is applied to find the critical buckling load in the structure. So as you can see, there is a bifurcation point which is located at the end of the linear part. So this point means the buckling point. At that point, buckling happens. And this time, in the y-axis, the buckling load can be shown here, which is also called the critical buckling stress or critical buckling load. So when you apply the arbitrary load in the system to reach the bifurcation point, ENSYS will create the load factor, or also known as load multiplier. So that means when you apply the load which can be lower or bigger than the critical buckling load, the ENSYS will apply the critical buckling load by the help of the load factor. So no matter how many force you apply. So after buckling happens, as you can see, plasticity part happens. So we are going to deal with the linear part today with the composite plates. So let's continue with ENSYS ACP module. With the help of the module, we can create the composite plates or the composite structures, and we can arrange the fiber directions by the help of this module. And after we model our structure, we are going to continue with the static structural to find the stress and the deformations. And after that, we can go through the eigenvalue buckling analysis. And at the end of this part, we can find the critical buckling load. So what is laminated composite plate? Basically, there will be some laminas in the plate, in the thickness. Each lamina can have their own angles, the fiber angles. And also each lamina can have their own thickness. So to make it easy to calculate, because we are going to make some analytical calculations, we are going to use unidirectional plate with 0 and 90 angles, and also each thickness will be 0 in the plate. So let's continue with the material properties and the plate stacking sequence. So our plies will be 0, 90, 90, 0 angles. So as you can see in the picture. So each ply will be 2.5 millimeter, and totally in the plate thickness will be 10 millimeter. So elastic modulus are given here, and also Poisson's ratio is given here. And then we are going to calculate the Poisson's ratio in 2-1 direction according to this formulation. And also shear modulus in the 1-2 direction is given here. So geometry and boundary conditions. There are some D values which is calculated from the D11, D22 and the D12 and D33 values. So D1 value is here, D2 value is here, and the D3 value is here. So if you want to know how to calculate the D values according to the material properties, you can check my video which is called as flexural stiffness calculations in my channel. You can check these results. I calculated them there. So let's continue with boundary conditions. The plate will be simply supported on all edges. So that means in the top of bottom edges, rotation of Y will be 0 and the displacement of Z will be 0. And in the left and right edges, rotation of X will be 0 and the displacement of Z will be 0. So our long edge of the plate will be 2 meter and the short edge of the plate will be 1 meter. So that means our aspect ratio will be 2. So the loading condition will be like that. 1000 newton per meter will be applied on two edges, as left and right, as a compressive forces. Actually, no matter how much force you applied, the load factor will be given at the end of the analysis. So there is a trick for the eigenvalue buckling analysis. When you are working shell structures, especially for the plates, sometimes when you are have a simply supported edges, sometimes rigid body motion cannot be prevented. So you need to apply some other boundary conditions to prevent the rigid body motion, especially for the simply supported plates. So that means we are going to apply some boundary conditions that does not any effect on the plate. So the middle node will be restrained in the X and Y directions. So that means middle node will be at the middle end of the analysis. And also the node which is parallel to the middle will be in the same direction with the middle node. So that means it cannot go up or down. So let's continue with the meaning of the modes, and also called mode shapes. The first one M is the half wave number in the X direction. So that means when you have three as a M, 1, 2, and 3 half waves will be observed in the X direction, and N means the half wave numbers in the loaded direction, that means Y direction, so which is usually 1. So for an example, when you have M value as 1, there will be 1 half wave, so when you have M equal to 3 and M equal to 2, you will observe 2 half wave number, and when you have M equals to 3, you will observe 3 half waves in the long edge, let's say. So there is a formulation for the all edges simply supported laminated composite plates. So that means critical buckling load is equal to, there is P and there is A, which is the length of the long edge in our case. So this is the M mode. So we are going to use D1, D2 and D3. And also there are modes and the plate lengths. Okay. So let's make a quick calculations for the mode 1-1, and our plate length is 2 meters and the mode is 1. D1 is here, D3 is here and D2 is here. So our mode is 1-1, so that means M and N will be 1 on the each case. So according to these calculations, critical buckling load will be 70 kilonewton per meter. So we are going to apply 1000 newton, so that means load factor will be 70.87, and there will be 1/2 wave in the long edge and 1/2 wave in the short edge in our case. So let's continue with ANSYS and let's take a look at what we find. So go to the ANSYS and carry the ACP pre-tool to the system. And we are going to define material properties. You can delete the static structural steel. Let's create the material which is called composite. So I'm going to use orthotrophic elasticity. I'm not going to use density because it's not going to be used in the buckling analysis. So let's make them megapascal. So let's remember the material properties. megapascal, and that will be 8 megapascal. That will be 0.27 ratio will be 0.27, and that will be 0.559, and that will be the same. So actually some of the values will not be used in this analysis, so we can have them as 5000 megapascal. So go to the geometry and right click on it as new design modular geometry. So go to the XY plane and click on new sketch, and let's take a look at. Go to the sketching and have a rectangle. Go to the dimensions and use length to distance. That will be long edge, and that will be short edge. 1 and 1, that will be 0.5 and 0.5 meter. So to create the shell structure, we are going to use surface from sketches and select the sketch one and click on apply and then click on generate. Our shell structure is created. Now we can close the window and go to the ANSYS and update the model. After you update the model and right click on it and click on edit. So in that case we are going to create the thickness and the material for the plate, and thickness will be 10 millimeter, the total thickness, and the material will be composite. And in that case we are going to create the mesh. Go to the element size and you can make it 10 millimeter. That will be accurate mesh. And the mesh is created, and we can close the window and go to the project. First of all, we need to define the unit, because ACP module does not have the unit. So click on the model and select the length unit as meter. Right click the model and click on update. So after it is updated, you need to update the ACP module. So right click on the setup and click on edit. Now we can create the composite layers and apply angles by the help of this module. So first of all we need to define the material and go to the material data and check the composite. Okay, that's right. So right click on the fabrics and create fabric. So the material will be composite and each thickness will be 0.07. Each ply will be 2.5 millimeter. So click on apply, and that is for the one layer. And I'm going to create this stack up to make four layer easily. That is the easiest method to create layers in the basic structures. So there will be four layers at 0, 90, 90 and 0, and click on apply and click on OK. So our stackup is ready. So I need to create the rosette. Right click on the rosette and click on create. So click on the origin and click on the arbitrary point which is located at the surface, and have a close view, and there is an red X direction, so that is the reference direction for the ply angles. So that means in that direction our fibers will be zero angle fibers will be located at this direction. So rosettes is for that. Click on OK and go to the oriented selection sets and create. So we are going to apply this for the all elements because our plate is simple, and click on the point and click on arbitrary point in the surface again, and the pink direction is the direction of the thickness. The layers will be stacked at this direction. So that is the meaning of the pink arrow. So go to the rosette and click on our created rosettes to define the reference angles and click on apply. Now we are going to use this oriented selection set in the fibers and go to the modeling groups and create modeling group, and right click on the modeling group and create ply. So we are going to use this oriented selection set, and ply material will be stack up, because if we use the fabric there will be one layer. We already prepared the four layers for the stack up one. Click on the apply, and now there is four layers in the plate. To check this, go to the layup plots and right click on the thickness and click on update. So there is a thickness 0.01 meter, that means 10 millimeter, and each part of the plate is 10 millimeter. So our job is done here with the composites, so you can close it. We need to update at the end of the process. So we can carry the static structural into the system, and we are going to connect the setup and the model, and we are going to choose transfer shell composite data because our structure is shell and we are working on the shell theory. So right click on the model and click on update. So now we are going to use the composite plate in the static structural by the help of this tool, and right click on the model and click on edit. So before we start the modeling, we can create the eigenvalue buckling tool. Carry the eigenvalue buckling tool to the solution. And now it is ready, and go to the static structural. So our mesh is already created from the previous parts. So we need to apply the boundary conditions and the forces. So right click on the first of all, let's create the selections. So click on right and top and bottom edges, and right click, create name selections as top and bottom, and do it for the left and right edges with the control, create name selections, and that will be right and left. So right click on the top and bottom, create nodal selections. So that will be top and bottom nodes. And right click on the right and left and create nodal selection. That will be right and left nodes. So I need to select the middle node. So to select the middle node, I'm going to use the coordinate system. Okay, I couldn't select. Okay, so that will be middle node. And to reach the side node, so there are some methods to find the nodes, but in that case the structure is basic, so I can use these tricks. Middle side node. So go to the static structural and insert nodal displacement 2 times, and we are going to create nodal orientation, not rotation, sorry, rotation for 2 times. So go to the first nodal displacement and click on top and bottom nodes, and Z direction will be 0, and go to the left and bottom nodes, left and right nodes, I'm sorry, the Z components will be 0, and for the simply supported case the rotation of Y will be 0 for the top and bottom, and rotation of X for the right and left edge edges will be 0. That is fixed. Okay, so I need to fix the middle node. So choose the middle node. X component will be 0 and Y component will be 0. So the side node should be restrained in the Y direction. So I need to apply the force as a line pressure, Newton per meter. Okay. So select the edge and go to the mode, select the single select, select the left edge and create the component as 1000 Newton per meter. And do it for the right edge again. Click the right edge and click on apply. -1000 Newton per meter. So okay, our plate is created, and go to the solution for the static structural and insert total deformation, and go to the eigenvalue buckling, click on the total deformation again, and go to the analysis settings for the eigenvalue buckling. Make the maximum modes defined 10. Let's see the 10 modes, and right click on the deformation and click on the solve. So before we check the results, let's remember the analytical calculation. For the mode 1-1, critical buckling load is 70 kN per meter. So load factor should be 70. So let's check the results, and it says load factor is 62. So what does it mean? So according to the aspect ratio, I'm expecting to see the critical buckling load in the mode 2. So mode 1-1 is not our critical buckling load. We need to check the mode 2-1 for the critical buckling load. And in the ANSYS, it says mode 1 is 62 with load multiplier. So it shows us the lowest value as a mode 1. So let's check the mode 2-1. That means there will be 2 half waves and the critical buckling load will be 62. So let's check the result. The critical buckling load is 62, and there are 2 waves, 2 half waves in the long edge in the loaded direction. And so let's check the old results. Right click on them and create mode shape results, and they are created in the solution, and right click on it and click on evaluate all results. So let's go to the calculations, and it says mod 1.1 will be 70. Go to the 70 as a mod 2, and so there will be one half wave in the long age and one half wave in the short age. So this is our mod 1.1, as you can see. And let's make another calculation for the, for example, mod 3.1. So according to the mod 3.1, critical buckling load will be 96 kN per meter. So that means load factor is here. So go to the results and find the mod 3 and click on the mod 3, and as you can see, 3 half waves in the long direction and 1 half wave in the loaded direction, as you can see here. So let's make it for the another mod. This is mod 2.2. So that means load factor will be 283. So that means there will be 2 half waves in the long direction and 2 half waves in the short direction. So which is here as a mod 8. Go to the mod 8. So in the mode 8, our load multiplier is correct, and the 2 half waves in the long direction and the 2 half waves in the short direction, as you can see, there will be 4 for this one. So that means our result is correct and the R shape is correct according to the analytical calculations, and that means our modeling is true. So if you like my video, please don't forget to like, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching.